Today we will learn about the water hammer effect. Okay, what is water hammer effect and how it can damage a system? What the system is, I will tell you in the further lecture. So let's learn the main topic. In a very small story, you will understand that what is the water hammer effect. Imagine that this is a cylinder. Okay, as I am showing by the help of arrow, this is a cylinder in which there is a piston. Okay, and this is an endless piston. Okay. And this is fitting inside the cylinder and it can slide inside the cylinder. Okay, grease is applied between the piston outer surface and cylinder inner surface. Okay, it can slide inside the cylinder. And suppose it is moving from left to right. Okay, and here there is a valve in bit. Okay, and it is moving with high velocity from left to right. Okay, so like this. Okay, now when it is moving, then suddenly this valve is closed. Okay, so it is a sort of restriction. Since the piston is very long and heavy in weight, what will happen with further movement, in case it is striking this restriction, that is the valve, it can shear it off, because the piston is coming with very high velocity and it will impart a very huge amount of force on this valve, so it will shear off. Okay, so same thing. Now suppose that through a long pipe some water is flowing inside the long pipe, you can see, and this is the valve. Okay, and this is the pressure gauge applied over here, as I am showing by the arrow. Okay, now what happens, suddenly suppose this valve is closed, water is moving with high velocity and this valve is suddenly closed, you know what will happen, that the water content, okay, which is over the left hand side of this valve, will act as a huge piston. Okay, because this is a pipeline in which it is fully filled with water, and water has high density. You know what is the density of water? That is 1000 kg per meter cube. So in case this pipeline is sufficiently long, then the water inside this pipeline will act as a heavy piston. Okay, that will strike this valve. Okay, and suddenly the pressure rise will take place just over the left hand side of this valve. This is what water hammer effect is. Okay, initially the pressure gauge is showing almost zero reading. Okay, or whatever the pressure over there is, it is showing that reading. But in case this valve is suddenly closed, then it shorts up. Okay, you can see the pressure rises to a very big magnitude. The reason I told that the left hand side of this flowing water is acting as a huge piston, which is giving a strike over here, sudden momentum change. Okay, so water has no way to skip away, so it enters this pressure gauge and high pressure is showing over here. Okay, similarly, the water content which is over the right hand side of this valve, okay, is also moving with high velocity. Okay, by this sudden closure, what will happen, it will keep on moving. Okay, so here some void will be created because it has its momentum to move in right hand side, so here some void is created. That void will create a sort of vacuum over here, so over here high pressure will be created and over here vacuum is created. Okay, this effect is called as water hammer effect. And you know, in case the pipe is not sufficiently strong, it can make the pipe to burst over the corresponding points where the strength of pipe is low. Okay, so hope you would have understood what is water hammer effect. Now in case we want to reduce this effect, very simple solution is there, that instead of closing this valve suddenly, close it gradually. Okay, so that the velocity of water gradually descends down and such type of sudden pressure rise doesn't take place. Okay, so generally sudden closure of any valve within the flow of water can lead to water hammer effect and can lead to damage to the pipeline in which the effect is happening. So hope you would have understood by this small study what water hammer effect is. Thank you.